Yes, good morning students. Now we are going to discuss the arithmetic mean last method. Hope you remember we have done the arithmetic mean for the integer series, which is I took the data without frequency, only the x value was given, and we have solved with the formula of x bar is equal to sigma x by n, and assume the mean method x bar is equal to a plus sigma d by n, and d denotes x minus a, deviation from x, and continuous series also we have done, which is x bar is equal to a plus sigma d dash by n into c. D dash denotes d by c, and c is a common factor. Everything we have done in the integer series, which is ungrouped data. Without frequency, only x values was given. Okay. We solved the value, and one more thing I used to say to you repeatedly, whichever formula you apply, it can be a direct method or assumed mean method or step deviation method, you will get the same answer. That's what arithmetic mean is known as unique method. Okay. And last class we have discussed about the discrete series. Calculation of arithmetic mean for the discrete series, which is grouped data with the frequency, the values was given, and we solved with the formula when the frequency is given, n is equal to total of frequency. And one more thing, we should multiply the x value in the f, then fx we will find, and summation of fx we got, and the formula for calculating the arithmetic mean in the discrete series is x bar is equal to sigma fx by n we found in the direct method, and for the assumed mean method we found x bar is equal to a plus sigma fd by n. Here d we found as the same procedure, deviation from x. We assume one small value from the x itself, and we deduct all the values of x from the assumed value. Okay, so that also we got. After getting the d value, we multiplied with the frequency. Okay, that also we found, and at last we did the step deviation method for the discrete series, isn't it? Step deviation formula: x bar is equal to a plus sigma f d dash divided by n into c. Okay, d dash is equal to d by c. Deviation we found in one column, no? That value should be divided by the common factor. The common factor how to take, I told you, which is common or divisible all the values in the d. Okay, the table you should choose as per the values by saying the d value. Okay, ma. And c is the common factor, a is the assumed value. So everything over for grouped data, discrete series we found. At last we are coming to the continuous series. Direct method we are going to solve. We are going to find the arithmetic mean for the continuous series values. Direct method, only direct method to do today, tomorrow same way assumed mean method. Hope you, those who are understood with the assumed mean method, d equal to x minus a, same procedure. But here the values x is given like this one. Continuous series 0 to 10, then there is a lower and upper limit is given. So hope you remember in second chapter when I was explaining the mid value or midpoint or class mark is equal to, what is the formula of calculating the mid value of the class mark, which is average of upper and lower limit. So here which is upper limit, the highest value of the series is known as upper limit, and lowest value of the series is known as lower limit. So here upper limit and lower limit divided by 2 is the mid value, upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. Okay, why I am explaining this, I will tell you first. When the values are given like this, how can we multiply with the frequency? The formula for calculating the continuous series for arithmetic mean is x bar is equal to sigma fm by n. fm, m denotes mid value, mid value. Okay, first we should find out the mid value. How do you find out the mid value? Mid value finding formula only, average of upper limit and lower limit. So average mean you will add the two values and divide by 2. Now if you want to find out the average of 5 students, you will add all the 5 numbers divided by 5 you found, no? Do you remember? Direct method. Integer series, how did you find the average mark of 7 students, average income of 7 families? Do you remember? 7 families value we added divided by number of Directly I am telling you, if you want to clarify, you can do by procedure only. See here, 20 plus 30 divided by 2, 50 by 2, 25 you will get. The same way, 30 plus 40 divided by 2, which is 70 divided by 2, 35 you will get. Next one, 40 plus 50 divided by 2, 90 divided by 2, 42, sorry, 45. Next one, 50 plus 60 divided by 2, 50 plus 60 divided by 2, average of upper and lower limit. So 60, 110 divided by 2, 55. Next one, 60 plus 70 divided by 2, how much now? 120 na? 65, 130 actually. 65, now I got a M value, middle value, okay? Mid value I got it. After, as per the formula requirement, what I should do? First of the steps for finding the continuous series, find the mid value, find mid value. Second, find sigma F or N, you know that. Which is total of F, sigma F, find the sigma F or N. Capital N denotes total of F. And third procedure, multiply F into M. Multiply F frequency into mid value. And fourth procedure is find sigma Fm, which is summation of F into M. What you calculated in this column, you have to get a total for it because the formula requirement, that's for the formula requirement. Find sigma Fm, that's all. Now this is the procedure for calculating the continuous series arithmetic mean in the direct method. Okay, direct method I am talking. Remember direct method formula. This is the formula of sigma Fm by N. M denotes mid value. When the lower limit and upper limit is given, you have to calculate like this. This is the formula to calculate the values. Now Fm I got it. Now F into M I am going to multiply. 5 5s are 25. 15 into 12, 180. Next to 375. 25 into 15, 375. Next to 35 into 25, 875. 875. Next to 8 into 45, 360. 360. Next to 3 into 55, 165. And 2 into 65, 130. Okay, ma. So this total you will get, ma, if you multiply these two. Now you have to get the total of these values. 2110 you will get once you do the totaling of these values. Now I got all the value. As for the EC method, what I said before, we have to write it separately. These values EC will substitute with the formula. So sigma n, n how much I got, ma? N equal to 70. Now I will write separately n is equal to 70 and sigma Fm is equal to 2110. Okay. Just these values you will substitute the formula, you will get an answer. Okay. X bar is equal to 2110 divided by 70. Cancel these two values, you will get a X bar value. X bar how much now? 30.14. 30.14. This is the X bar answer. That's all, ma. Very simple procedure. When the values are given in the continuous series, you will find the mid value. After finding mid value, multiply with the frequency, get the total and frequency total. Substitute to the formula. You will get the answer. Then we will discuss the another example, ma, exercise sum. Same way, calculate arithmetic mean by direct method. See the question is given 60 X value. You can see the lower limit and upper limit in the question itself. So you can identify this is continuous series. Discrete series, last class how it was there? X equal to 20, 10, 20, 30, 40 like that. And frequency value 2, 4, 6, 8 like that was there. So directly multiply with the F into X, isn't it? You got the sigma F and Fx. Fx, sigma Fx you got it. And you substitute with the formula of X bar equal to sigma Fx by N. This is last day class for the discrete series. Okay. Now I am doing the continuous series. So no need of doing these things and all. You have a lower limit and upper limit. So you should find the average of these two. What as per the formula, what you should find first? Mid value. So next column getting is mid value. So before going to write the column, you write the formula. Then you will identify what to find out. Sigma F into M divided by N. So N is for total of frequency. How much total of frequency? divided by 2 is equal to 85 plus 95 divided by 2. 95 plus 105 divided by 2. 105 plus 115 divided by 2. 115 plus 125 divided by 2. 125 plus 135 divided by 2. Next, 135 plus 145 divided by 2. So now you are going to get the average of all the values, that is mid value mark. So add these all the values, you will get the average, that is mid value. 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120, 130, 140. If you see here, immediately you will find out 65 to 75. 10 difference is there, which is middle value will be there. Obviously, 65 to 70. 70 is middle value. Next, 75 to 85, middle value obviously 80. 5 difference is your partition. If you make a partition of two values, you get a middle value. Then 85 to 95, 90. 95 to 105, 100. So, middle value. You can directly, those who are smart, they will find out the mid value easily. Or you go with the proper procedure, mid value equal to average of upper and lower limit. So, upper value 75 plus 85 divided by 2. Okay. Now I got the mid value mark. Just you have to multiply the mid value into frequency as per the formula requirement. See here, multiply F into M. So, after multiplying, what are the values I am getting? You see, before only I have calculated peak values mark. If you get a simple question, you practice with a simple question, no need of calculating this much big values. Okay, 10,350. Next one, 100 into 95, 9,500. Next one, 110 into 70. 110 into 70, I am multiplying these two ma. 70 into 110, 7,700. 7,700. 60 into 120, 7,200. Next, 40 into 130, 5,200. Last, 25 into 140, 3,500. So, these values we got. After from multiplying the frequency with the mid value, you should get a total of it, that is sigma Fm. So, what is the value? 65,150. 65,150. Now, we will write separately all the values. M equal to 695. Sigma Fm is equal to 65,150. Understood? So, I have written separately to substitute with the formula. Now, directly I am going to substitute with the formula. 65,150 divided by 695. Cancel these two, you will get the x bar value. X bar is 93.74. Okay? So this is the forward mark. You need not confuse with the big values. If you have an exercise or textbook, you have an exercise page after completing the chapter, you take a small values to solve this problem. So procedure for the direct method formula is x bar is equal to sigma fm by n. Okay. If you are clear with this only, tomorrow we can go with the assumed mean method. Assumed mean method is nothing but sigma ft by n we will do much. Sigma x bar, x bar is equal to a plus sigma ft by n, as it is we will write. Here d denotes x minus m. A, M minus A, you will write. Now, instead of writing X, here mid value only consider as X, because we can't do any multiplication for these two series, continuous series, 65 to 75, 75 to 80. How can you multiply? You can multiply with only lower limit or upper limit, it's not possible. That's what we are going to find out the average.